honored to meet this young man today, okay? He is the one that has been spreading the good news about Ghana and a Sable Village. And so we came today to check it out, and he is helping us check it out. So you want to say hi to my 2 or 3 subscribers?
Okay, hey, thank you very much for checking it. I want to do like I do all the time.
Yes.
Hey, thank you very much for checking me. My name is Eko Simpson.
Yes.
Today is the 21st of December.
Yes.
And I'm happy to meet these beautiful
people
right here. They are my family, you know.
So, yes.
So yes, we've been having some conversation on Instagram, and today we're here just because nature is connecting us, right?
That's right.
Yeah, so we are here in Cape Coast right now. And we're going to check the Asebo land. And then before that, we have to meet Obed, who is the operational manager of the whole project. So we're here today. I want to say thank you guys for checking it out. And then if you're watching, yes, that's it. And if you're watching this video on my channel, make sure you check out her YouTube channel.
Yes.
I'll put it in the description below.
Yes.
Then, you know, we can start getting the followers.
Yeah, so Eko, we're here in the Cape Coast, and we know you're from the Cape Coast,
yeah.
Right? Beautiful place. Remember when it was just dirt roads?
Yeah.
And it's all paved. They even have street signs where you don't get lost anymore.
Yeah.
So, I mean, but so we're going to be here for a few hours, so where should we go? What should we see? What should we eat? Is there a restaurant, somewhere to sit or go? Give me the short version of how you would tell me.
Okay, Cape Coast is known for its traditional meal. We call it intiti.
Intiti?
Intiti.
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 Okay.
Yes, intiti.
Give me 12 fries, I'll give it to you.
Yeah, so intiti is cooked fish. But it doesn't come like a stew.
Okay.
It's just that with sliced tomatoes and onion.
Okay.
So you don't cook like you're cooking a stew. You just
right.
cook the fish, mm-hmm. and then you slide the tomatoes and the onions, and you put them on it, and then you
okay.
just take it.
Sounds
yeah,
good.
Like that. So you're going to have that with kinky.
Kinky.
But mostly, when you come to Cape Coast, and I want to recommend a place for you, I want to take you to a place where you can feel the breeze.
Oh,
yes.
So you can have some bangku.
Oh, yes.
Some tilapia.
Okay.
And if you're like me, maybe a bottle of beer.
Okay.
Yes. Okay.
Oh,
okay.
Oh,
okay.
That's
good.
That's yes.
Okay.
So there's
yes.
a place called The Breeze.
The breeze.
The Breeze, yes.
Okay.
And the owner of the place is just like my brother right here.
Hey.
Strong.
Yeah, strong.
Strong. That's
yeah,
how
strong.
We say.
Yeah, so maybe that is the place I recommend for you.
Okay.
You sit there, relax. Your customer service is beautiful.
Okay.
And so, and just by the seaside. So you have the breeze whilst you're taking your meal. And
nice.
Perfect.
Yeah.
So when we get to the debris, go to the breeze, then we'll show you some footage of that.
Exactly.
And if everything goes well, we're going to be happy with that. But if it doesn't go well, we're going to have a new interview with
yeah.
that about the breeze.
And I have to recommend a different place.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
But I
hope
you
know. We know everything we've had in Ghana has been
good.
Delicious.
So but I have a question. How did you realize that? I mean, there's a place like Ghana, Africa, and you needed to make that step to come here.
By going. By getting on a plane and going.
Okay.
And exploring.
Right.
And not just saying, I don't like this.
Mm-hmm.
This didn't work, or they did this. You go, you meet local people, you make friends.
Yeah.
The motherland is full of our brothers and sisters.
Yeah.
So it's just a matter of going and connecting.
Right, and the reason I'm sorry to interrupt.
Yeah.
The reason we chose Ghana was when our first time coming to Africa was 2010. We've been coming every year
okay.
since, gone every year. And the reason we chose Ghana was because we were looking for countries, and this is our own selfish reasons, that spoke English,
yeah.
that was safe,
yeah.
had a good had some Christians in it. Not that we cared, but it was just we knew that many of the places that had heavy Christianity tend to have a certain character about them. And also that made products, you know, that had some history. And so when Obama was elected in 2008, one of the first places he went to was the Cape Coast Castle. Yes. And then so we, from there, we kind of researched, we figured if Obama went there, then something must be going on that they fixed. I know they fixed something, right? Yeah. When we go there. Right. So that's what we looked at. So that's what we did. And we stayed most of our time in the Cape Coast. We went through the castles. We've taken the tour about four times.
And friends here to tour in January. Okay. So we were here in January at the start of the year, mm-hmm. and we're thankful that we're here at the close.
Yeah.
It's a good thing, it's a beautiful thing.
Yeah. you're here purposely for their sable lands, right? You want to build? Like, what is the vision for?
You know, we have so many things that we're wanting to do right now. Not only just the free land. This time that we're here, we've actually gone and spoken with architects and developers, other people who have land that's here, and to just try to see what it is that we want to do. We definitely know that we want to build here in Ghana, but it's just a matter of finding that perfect spot. So we think we're close to that perfect spot.
Okay.
So we'll just have to, but for a Sable Village, we really want to, you know, check it out, learn more about the meaning. We're here on the ground now, so what better time than to, you know, connect and say, okay, what is, we're hearing from your excellent videos what it's about, but just being on the ground and checking it out. But we've been doing a lot of moving around. Do we want to rent first?
Mm-hmm.
Do we want to purchase land? And just kind of lining it up, doing due diligence,
mm-hmm.
not just looking at YouTube. Mm-hmm. Not that that's a bad thing, because you have an excellent channel, we're growing, but you want to do your due diligence, because if you do not do your due diligence, then you will have a problem.
Yeah, because one of the real, and I'll real short, because when you come to different parts of Africa, Cape Coast and other parts, some of the places are so beautiful, so spaced out, you just say, oh, I love this. I love to have land. And there's always some guy who's willing to sell you somebody else's land. and you're so happy because you see it and it's cheap and you're like, okay.
Right.
Next thing you know, five other people own the land.
Right.
So you have to do your due diligence. Yeah. You have to follow people, watch people. Mm-hmm. You have to get recommendations. I mean, it's just a few things you have to kind of do. You have to try to understand the laws,
mm-hmm.
even though it's new to us, but we are getting a good understanding of how the law works, that there is a strong legal system here in Ghana. You just have to know how to use it. You know, I've heard of horror stories with the legal system here in the United States.
Yeah.
But that's the thing, just do your research, your due diligence.
You know what, that part doesn't bother me.
Mm-hmm.
It's not very much that does bother me. I really love the motherland. It's a difference, it's a developing country. But from 2010 to now, Ghana has grown leaps and bounds.
Yeah.
This place, Cape Coast, 10 years ago, it was dirt, dirt road, right? Even coming here was dirt road. So now, you know, this is what I always say. Africa is rising, and it's rising very rapidly. It has a youthful population, and it has a population of people who are moving, who are bettering the continent.
Yeah.
Once, and I always say, we're the missing link. Once we come home and connect and collaborate, bang, there it goes.
Okay.
We'll be, so it's not much that I really can't say anything to that. I mean, it's different because I don't expect to come here and it be like the US.
Yeah.
Are things, does it take longer to do something?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. The traffic in Accra, now that one.
Yes.
Ooh, now that is like, oh, But not too much. I already have an understanding that cash is king still here. We get a little frustrated.
That is one of the things that one of the things that can throw you off if you're not ready for it.
Right.
You go to a lot of places and even, you know, like getting gas, getting hotels, a lot of places still only accept cash.
Right.
And the issue is, like, if someone is coming here, you better have more than one way to get cash.
True.
Right.
Because what will happen is if your bank cuts you off because they're suspicious, then next thing you know, you don't have any cash and you don't have any access, and you're sitting around waiting. You have to wait a whole cycle, a day cycle, because you're half a day ahead. You have to wait multiple hours or whatever to call and sort things out. It may take a day. So that's important. The other thing is, like places like Accra, they need a way to order stuff online that's quick.
Okay.
And as much as I despise Amazon with their monopoly, they do have a good system where you order something, you can get it within a day or two. Better than U.S. at. I mean, I think what happens in U.S., we were a desktop and PC technology, and now we're moving to cell phones. Ghana was on cell phones years ago. They started on that because of how inexpensive and efficient it was. So it's a few other things. You just have to kind of get used to it. There's things you just have to get used to. I mean, sometimes the goat is gonna take the right of way on the street. You know, you have to let the goat go by. You know? I like that though.
Oh, right.
But anyway.
This is the first time of checking them out. I'll put their YouTube channel down there. Subscribe and learn more about coming to Ghana, Africa. That's what it is. Thank you for checking me out. Bye. Bye.